This week, we're back in Pike Road, Alabama, working on the kitchen at our house. The builder we bought our house from chose a lot of colors and finishes that aren't exactly in keeping with our cottage style. So we're on a mission to freshen this space up and give it a light, bright, farmhouse fresh feel.
I'm Layla, part vlogger, part designer. And one of my favorite things to do is help folks see the possibilities in their design dilemmas. Whether we're picking out new paint colors or redesigning an entire room, I love it.
We've already painted the walls a nice light gray color, so we're going to start on the stove side of the room by working on the cabinets, counters, and backsplash.
Okay, the backsplash is in and it's time to start painting. Okay, the cabinets on the walls are all painted. I think I ended up doing about 4 coats. White is tricky, but I'm working on the doors now, and I just wanted to share with you a little tip that I have found to work awesome. It's to use a little itty bitty roller for the flat parts of the door. You can get in the edges with a brush, but this is the key to getting a killer smooth factory finish, whether it's this kind of regular roller head or a sponge roller. And a big part of that is to not overload it. You want to be able to see through it, basically, when you put your first coat on. And I usually think that one roller head full of paint should get the whole surface. But you should be able to see through it, like I said, a little bit. Kind of end off with some long swoops. Let it dry and do it about 4 more times.
Once the stove side of the room was done, we turned our attention to the island.
And that brings us to today. The backdrop is totally done and it's time to decorate. Okay, let's talk about finishes and design details. We went with white cabinets on the stove side of the room and a heather gray island in the center of the room. But we used the same white quartz on both sides just to keep everything cohesive. I found the cabinet knobs at a local home improvement store, and I ordered the drawer pulls from a website online. And I just love them because they look like little rolling pins, perfect for a cottage kitchen. I found this secretary at a flea market a couple years ago, and it's lived in our sunroom for quite a while. But when we figured out that we could use it in here and there was still plenty of room to pass by, we had to drag it in. I painted it mint green to tie in with the backsplash and to add another pop of color that coordinated with the rest of what's going on in here. Probably my favorite thing in the whole space are these new old corbels. There were corbels here, but they were pretty basic, didn't have a lot of character. These have tons of character. My friend Lucy found them at a salvage shop, and we just had her strip them back, get rid of all the layers of paint. I love that some of it still hung on. Brian the carpenter had to cut them down just a little bit, but they were pretty easy to attach once they were the right size. And to bump up the farmhouse feel a little bit more, we had him add some X's to the sides of the island, just to mimic the look of a barn door. Hands down, my favorite decor item in the whole space is this French door that I had a local glass company turn into a mirror. I wanted to make the most of this wall with something big, but that didn't stick out very far and didn't look very messy. And I love the way this door speaks to the other wood tones in the room. And because it's a mirror, it adds depth to the space. We decided to go a little bolder on the backsplash. A, because it's a small area, we didn't have to cover a lot of space. And B, because you can see it from anywhere you stand on our first floor. And luckily, we had a little bit left so we could do the strip on the island. This week, we're back in Pike Road, Alabama, working at the kitchen. We're working at the kitchen, making some meals. So, we're on a mission to freshen up the space and give it a light, bright, farmhouse fresh feel. I found the knobs at a local home improvement store and the poles. Oh, that's a tongue twister. Hair is stuck in the crease of my glasses. Oh, it broke. Nope, it's still in there. Let's pull it. Oh, now there's a whole bunch of them. Can you help me? Can you get them out? Thank you. Lost my bangs.